Welcome to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neal Howard, for this Health Supplier segment. Our guest is Dr. Leonard P. Guarente, Director of MIT's Glenn Laboratory for Science of Aging, here to talk with us about Elysium Health, a startup company that's dedicated to bringing scientific breakthroughs to consumers. Thank you so much for joining us today, Leonard Guarente.
My pleasure. Well, I've been a professor at MIT for about 37 years, and I've studied aging for about 26 years. I've run a lab here over that period of time, and we spent about 10 years from 1990 to 2000 trying to identify important proteins in the aging process. And we identified a series of proteins called sirtuins that are important in aging. And we've been trying to figure out how to leverage that finding into therapeutics for health ever since.
So we're not talking about not aging. We're talking about aging in better health, maybe a bit slower. Is that the goal here? Is that the research, the direction that we're going in?
Yeah, I think that there's a word that gets used called healthspan that I think is what we're most interested in. And what that means is retaining good health for as long as possible so that you can do the things you enjoy, you can continue to work at your job, and so on and so forth. And to me, that's really the most important thing.
Health span versus lifespan, not just living longer, but living healthier for as long.
Yeah, living healthier longer. Mm-hmm. That's right.
What are some of the emerging scientific innovations?
Well, I think a lot of the work that we've done and other labs have done have really shown a relationship between metabolism in cells and aging. And so the proteins we're most interested in my lab, sirtuins, are really involved in cellular metabolism and cellular health. And so we're really interested in being able to keep these proteins as active as they can be for as long as possible inside our bodies. And if we can do that, we believe that that will deliver a health benefit and will give our health span a boost.
What are you and Elysium Health doing toward that end?
Well, Elysium Health is a company that's based on the premise that there are natural compounds, compounds that are in nature, in the food supply, and so on, that are healthful. And in the area that we study, we know of two such compounds. One of them is an activator of one of the sirtuins, and the other is a small natural compound that cells can turn into something called NAD, which is very important for cellular energy. And so what we've done with Elysium is take these natural compounds, the two of them, and put them in pure form inside of a pill, a product, that we call Basis.
Yeah.
And we think that by combining these two, we will give sort of the maximum boost possible to the activity of these sirtuins, and therefore will keep them as active as they can be for as long as they can be. Now, what happens if you don't intervene, what happens normally, is that the levels of NAD inside of cells go down as we get older, and the activity of sirtuins, which require NAD, also goes down. So we lose the benefit of this metabolism boost that will slow down aging and preserve good health. So we hope to be able to short-circuit that problem by this product, which combines these two natural compounds that can keep cells healthier longer via good metabolism.
Does this longevity spill over into cognitive function as well? I mean, if we're doing better physically, aren't we going to do better mentally? Are the two related, and do these enzymes affect that?
I think they are related. There's a lot of preclinical data in the laboratory that shows benefits conferred by these compounds on neurons and on the brain and on cognitive function. So I think that although there's no human data on this at this time, we believe that cognitive improvement is likely to occur. Now, I should say the other aspect of Elysium that I think distinguishes it from companies that offer natural compounds as products is we really believe in testing them in human trials and to make no claims at all that are not based on rigorous scientific data. So we've really made a bedrock of the company based on science and robust, rigorous data.
Well, what were some of the results from the trial on BASIS?
Well, we completed our first trial. I think there are going to be numerous trials on BASIS to test for numerous functions, for such as preserving muscle, preserving cognition, preserving overall health, and so on and so forth. The first trial that we did was a drug company would call a phase one kind of a trial to just get even more data than already existed, and some existed already, on safety, but also to show that this product would boost NAD levels in cells. This is kind of a critical aspect of the activity of this product, is that it will boost NAD levels, and that will confer better health on our cells, and therefore on our organs and on our whole bodies. And so the trial was a two-month trial, and it was run with a placebo control. Everybody was blinded. The participants in the trial were blinded. The doctors were blinded. And we had people take for 2 months either a single dose of BASIS or double the normal dose of BASIS. And then we measured the levels of NAD in blood cells in these people, and we found that, indeed, BASIS very significantly and robustly increased NAD levels. So we can now say that this product will raise NAD levels in a sustainable way. It did so for the entire duration of the trial, which was 2 months. And therefore, we can now really start to drill down on more specific endpoints of health to see if we see benefits of BASIS. And we think that the next phase of trials will address those questions.
When it comes to BASIS, have the folks who are going to be using the product going to be of a certain age for maximum efficacy of this product, or is this something that you should start, say, in your early 30s?
Yeah, I mean, I think to some degree that a choice the consumers will make, but I believe that the BASIS will be effective in healthy people, in maintaining health. So I think people who are middle-aged or even older would take this product and, you know, we're doing trials, but the hope is we'll benefit from it and they'll be healthier for longer. I mean, I think younger people could certainly take it. It's safe. But I think it would probably be, looking from my eyes, as somebody who's not young, I certainly want to be able to take this product and have taken it for 3 years now in order to best maintain my health, along with, you know, diet and exercise. It's not a substitute for those things, but I think, you know, in combination with a healthy lifestyle, this will be, you know, another aid to health maintenance.
Now, you're also the author of Ageless Quest, One Scientist's Search for Genes That Prolong Youth. Where can we get a copy of your book and learn some more about BASIS?
Amazon carries the book, so you can get a copy of the book there.
And we can learn more about BASIS at Elysium Health's website?
That's right. The website has a lot of information. I mean, we're really trying and dedicated to being as open and as informative as possible for our customers, so they'll know what everything that's known about the science behind BASIS, and we'll certainly keep refreshing the website as new information becomes available.
And that would be ElysiumHealth.com?
That's right.
Great. Well, it's been a pleasure, Dr. Leonard P. Guarente. Thanks so much for coming in.
Well, thank you.
You've been listening to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host, Neal Howard. Transcripts and audio of the program are available at healthprofessionalradio.com.au and also at hpr.fm. You can subscribe to the podcast on iTunes, listen in, and download at SoundCloud. And be sure and visit our affiliates page at hpr.fm at healthprofessionalradio.com.au.